Hello, I'm Mr. Harmandir, a retired lecturer in mythology, preaching Christianity and Sikhism. Sikhism is continuation of Christianity, and Nanak was the second coming of Jesus. And here I'm rendering exposition of St. John 12:44-50. Holy Gospel of our Supernatural Father Elohim, Allah, Parbrahm, etc. Delivered by the First Anointed Christ, which in Punjabi we call Satguru Jesus, according to St. John 12:44-50. Jesus cried out and said, "Whoever believes in me, believes not only in me, but also in the one who sent me," because Jesus was doing the will of our Supernatural Father. So whoever perceived Jesus perceived the one who sent him. And whoever sees me performing the miracles perceives, as Nicodemus has perceived, and not sees the one who sent me. Remember, Nicodemus once born and seeing the miracle, then he said, he perceived, you know, that unless you are from God, you can't perform such miracles. But the other crook rabbis, they were jealous of Jesus because their position was shaken. As today, the hireling doctor priest in churches, they are anti-Christ. They work for money and they are Judas Iscariot in sheep's clothing. Judas Iscariot used to hold the purse, and whenever he wanted money, he would steal money from the purse. Same way, these local priests working in these churches, they put their hand into the church purse at the end of the month and draw money as their salaries. They are not royal priests, they are just priests of the order of the one Jesus got rid of. In them is fulfilled Matthew 12:43-45. And then the situation became worse than before the arrival of Jesus. So you have to be careful. Everyone has to give his own account to God. So you have to be master of your own destiny. People who are masters of their own destiny, they are male. And those who are not, they go by what Pope say, this man say, that man. They are married to that man. They are females. They are not masters of their own destiny. But their destiny is governed by Pope and his stooges. I came into the world as light, which in Urdu we call Noor, so that everyone who believes in me might not remain in darkness. So Jesus had the knowledge of the Oral Torah, and Oral Torah is the light, is logo. It cannot be written down in ink on paper, as logo is written over your heart when you do the logical reasoning. So those who do the logical reasoning, they get logo, and that is here. And then they can preach gospel with authority. That is called drinking the blood of Christ. Hearing Jesus is called eating the flesh of Jesus. And preaching gospel, drinking the blood of Christ. If anyone hears my words and does not observe them, I do not condemn them. I do not condemn him. For I did not come to condemn the world, but to save the world. So in Jesus, whatever you do, so shall you reap. So you don't need to blame anyone. If people suffer because they have done bad deeds or they have gone wrong, like in Libya, Syria, other places, they have become Muslims of the physical body. A Muslim is one who is inwardly, not outwardly. And they have, by becoming Muslim of physical body, they have broken their covenant with their tribal elders. And then they become people, they have become the people that have not been sown by Yahweh, the farmer. That's why Jesus said, every plant, every person that my heavenly Father, Yahweh, did not plant, is not, has covenant with Yahweh, shall be uprooted by the root. They will be killed. That's what's happening in the world now. And these tears are getting bundled up in Israel, because when they become Jew outwardly, then they break their covenant with Abraham, because Abraham was not a Jew, he was a Semitic race. So when they break the covenant with Abraham, then they become unfaithful to Yahweh. Yahweh is the one who is the Lord of the nature. So that is the Heavenly Father of Jesus. So they can't live on this planet Earth. They too die. Tears will burn and kill each other, as is happening in the Jerusalem and in Israel and the Gaza, Palestinian, both are tears. Abraham was neither a Muslim of physical body, not a Jew, but some Semite. So both are anti-Semitic. And both anti-Semitic, they are killing each other. If they become sons of Abraham, they can live in peace. Whoever rejects me, does not accept my words, has something to judge him. So those who don't, you know, go by the will of our supernatural Father, then they go by the will of the Satan. As people go for the will of Pope, whatever Pope say, they do it. And where the Pope goes, there the people go. Pope is Antichrist, and so you can't find peace in him. And does not accept my words, has something to judge him, his own deeds, you know. The word that I spoke, it will condemn him on the last day, as you can see in Iraq, Libya, Syria, etc. That means every plant which my heavenly Father did not plant shall be uprooted, killed. That's what's happening. Because I did not speak on my own, but the Father who sent me commanded me what to say. That means he's inside me. This is the temple of God. God lives in his temple inside me. I'm his royal priest. If I go, what my Father wishes me to say. Not if I go against my Father, then I'm working for Satan. And speak. And I know that his commandment is eternal life. So what I say as the Father told me. That is what I say, what my Father, which is Elohim, Allah, Parbrahm, has told me to say, that you go by logical reasoning, not illogical. And that produces logo, which is his word. And that is gospel. So that's it. So our supernatural Father, Allah, Parbrahm, etc., blesses you, because in agape we hate none, we love everyone.